Hey everybody, welcome back to my channel, Precious Robins with Precious Pythons. And for those of you that are joining us for the first time, welcome and thank you for watching. I am going to be making a video today to show you guys how I photograph my snakes on a blank background. So as you can see here, I have a few things set up. I have my light box and some foam boards set up in the corners to demonstrate a blank background. So I'm gonna go ahead and pull out some of my snakes. You'll see a few different morphs that I have, and we'll just go ahead and get right into it. Alright guys, so this is my girl Mazakine. She's pretty big. I'm gonna see if she'll stay still to let me photograph her. We'll see. See if I can get a few good shots in of her. But she is an orange dream het clown. She's about 1,000 grams, very huge, very active. She obviously doesn't like the light, but we're gonna see if we can get her to cooperate and I can get her to give me some good pictures. Okay, for this next beauty, this is Amethyst. She is a yellow belly spark. As you know, it's a puma, and she is so gorgeous. She's a female, she weighs about 300 grams. And I'm gonna go ahead and take some shots of her now. I'm gonna do the foam, the white foam boards, the black foam boards, and I'm gonna put her in the light box. We'll see which photos come back out better, which backgrounds come out better. I guess you guys can be the judge of that as well. You can comment down below and tell me which background you like her better on. Now, one thing I do want to show you guys is when you have a baby ball python, a hatchling, or a juvenile, because I think she's considered a juvenile at this point. if they're moving around a lot while you're trying to photograph them, you can literally just ball them up with your hands and they should cooperate for at least like 30 seconds, long enough for you to get a photo. It doesn't really work with the big ball pythons because good luck trying to ball them up in a ball in your hands. But with the babies, all you would really have to do is ball them up nice and tight, just like that. And then set them down and she'll be balled up like that for some time, which makes her easy to photograph. So ever having trouble like I just described, just try that method and it should go smoothly. Like she's just not gonna move at that point. Now some, you know, all snakes have their own personality, so it may not work on all, but it should work on most. All right, so here's Loki. He is my yellow belly genetic stripe. He's about 550 grams. I'm hoping he's going to cooperate with me, but he's moving a lot here, so. It is about 6 o'clock and we're coming up on their feeding day, so they're really active. But let's go ahead and see if I can get some pics of him. So Loki was a little difficult for me, so I put him away and now we're on to snake number 4. So this is Sage. She is a hypo possible het clown. Gonna have to prove her out to my visual to see if she does carry the gene. But she is fresh out of shed. She just came out of shed yesterday, so she's looking extra gorgeous today. And I'm gonna see if she'll let me get some pictures of her. She is also very active today. So I don't know if I'm gonna get any successful pics, but we'll see. I just need you guys to look at this difficultness that I have to deal with right now. She will not stop moving. So thank you guys for watching and entertaining my little photo shoot. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did like the video, please subscribe to my channel, like and comment down below. Let me know if you like the black background versus the white background, or if you like the photo box here, light box that I have. I'll go ahead and drop a link down in the description so you know where I purchased it from. Just keep in mind when using it that you're gonna wanna put smaller snakes in it versus large adult snakes. But until then, I'll see you guys next Thursday. And again, thank you for watching.